Today, we're going to look at the basic structure of an abstract. First, let's think about why your abstract is so important. It provides all the information potential readers need to judge whether the study is important, which of course it is. It's a self-contained piece of writing. It says everything that the full paper says, but in brief. Never forget that most people searching databases just skim the abstracts. They only read the full article if the abstract is interesting, well written, and relevant. This is your best chance to grab potential readers' attention. Now, what do you put into your abstract? You can use the memory aid IMRAD to remember the key sections. Firstly, the introduction. Secondly, the method. Next, you have the results. And finally, you should cover the discussion. Your abstract may be structured using the IMRAD headings or unstructured in a single paragraph, but either must contain essentially the same information. Remember, there's a strict word limit, usually 100 to 250 words. Now, let's look at each of those sections individually. Let's start with the introduction. You need to state the problem addressed by your study, but briefly. Three sentences at most is good. Tell the reader why it is important, how the study aims to solve the problem, and what the research question was. Next up, you should cover the method. Here you briefly describe how the study was conducted. Define the sample and materials. Explain the data collection method. And lastly, describe how the data was analysed. Now, you should talk about the results. You need to state the main findings. Only include the most important results. And you should highlight the relationships that answer the research question. Finally, you must consider the discussion. It's really important to state the implications of the findings. What is their theoretical significance? If relevant, what is their implementation in practice? And be sure to end with a strong conclusion. Now, let's take a few seconds to look at what you should not do. You should only cite other work if the study is directly related. Be sure not to state anything that is not in the main text. It should be understandable by a general readership, so don't use any technical terms or jargon that needs to be explained. It's not good to use abbreviations unless a term is very long and repetitive. If you must, be sure to define it. Finally, check carefully, get others to give feedback, and revise until it can't be improved anymore. Good luck!